Hi there, welcome to Fact Friday. This week I'm talking about baseline logic. Baseline logic refers to experimental reasoning inherent in single subject experimental designs. But guys, keep in mind that baseline logic does work differently in each design, so make sure you're familiar with the specific ways that the elements work within all the different designs. My discussion today is going to be the general defining features of baseline logic and the four elements of baseline logic. So let's start with the first element, prediction. This is the predicted or projected result of the intervention. Think of it as a hypothesis that predicts that if you don't do something, the behavior is going to stay as it is, not improve. It's sort of the reason for intervening, right? So we intervene, which leads us to phase two, affirmation of the consequent. When we intervene and responding changes with the presentation of that independent variable, the intervention, IV, what is shown is that the IV is in fact controlling the behavior and possibly showing a functional relationship between the IV and the DV, the behavior. But since it's only one indication, we can't stop there, right? One effective IV implementation doesn't confirm or prove anything in regards to that IV's efficacy. So we've got to move on to phase three, verification. In this phase, what we have is a little help showing that the IV does in fact have control over the behavior. And what it verifies for us is that the IV is probably responsible for the change, because in this phase, we see that the behavior at baseline levels without the IV returns to those baseline levels, right? And of course, number four, replication. This is the most important phase because here we strengthen the proof of our findings by reintroducing the independent variable. And here, if the results are similar to previous outcomes in the previous independent variable conditions, it lets us know that the independent variable works every time. This phase provides us with a demonstration of reliability and believability. Each of these elements depends on an overall experimental control or experimental approach called steady state strategy. Important vocabulary word as well. When experimental conditions or changes in experimental conditions are introduced after stable patterns of responding in each condition and all the other influences on the behavior have been controlled for, what we have is confirmation that these stable levels of responding are the product of the specific conditions, baseline or treatment, and nothing else. Don't you just love science? I do. I hope that helps, guys, and I'll see you next time.